as something called modern money theory. This is not a term that we came up with. I think that others who began to follow our work branded us with this title and started referring us to us as the modern money school and to our ideas as modern money theory. And in many ways, I think it's kind of unfortunate that this is the brand that we now, or the cross that we now bear, because it is something of a misnomer. What we're doing is actually not modern at all. The ideas are not theoretical, and they aren't particularly modern. What we're doing is simply describing operationally the way government finance works. Okay, it's not a theory. We do not make assumptions, although we are economists. What we've been describing to you today is not dependent upon any cateris paribus condition or any set of assumptions about perfect competition or rational agents or anything else that you get exposed to when you study economics, but rather an attempt to simply describe the way in which the institutional arrangements are set up and the accounting identities and what happens in a balance sheet framework. When one side of the equation moves, what happens on the other side of the equation? And that's really all we're up to. So don't be afraid. As I said, the ideas aren't particularly modern. I could have filled the page with names of folks who've come before us espousing exactly the same kinds of things that we're talking about here today. One of the earliest was a German economist by the name of George Friedrich Knapp, who wrote a book called The State Theory of Money. Many of the same ideas that you're hearing from us today can be found in the work of Knapp. They can be found in Keynes, most specifically in his Treatise on Money, published in 1930, and they can most surely be found in the work of Abba Lerner, who wrote extensively on this kind of a thing, publishing papers with titles like Money as a Creature of the State. So they are neither modern nor are they theoretical. But we like them.